Today we're going to talk about how to set up the TMC2209 with UART, sensorless homing, Big Tree Tech GTR version 1.0. So I'm only going to do the x-axis so I can show you what's occurring right here. In order to do that, currently it's set up for SPI with all these pins. So what we need to do is remove these jumpers over here. We're going to pop these out and hopefully not make a mess of things here. They're kind of in a place where it's hard to track them. Apparently my thumb gets in the way. Let's see if I can get this one out real quick here. There we go. So the UART is actually two pins located right over here. You have one pin and another, so you have to jump that. Put a jumper on it, then I'm going to push it down. Now for the actual stepper, I already have the cooling fins on it. I recommend that you have a cooling fan on it when you're running it. But as you can see, the pins align with the colors, so I'm just going to plug that in. Now in order to operate this, we're going to need power. So I'm going to fold this back, and as you can see, the power is disconnected while I'm working with it. So I'm going to slide in first the power for the motors. So what you're going to do is you're going to put the voltage side in first, then you're going to tighten that down. Then you're going to put in the ground side, tighten that down. Then you can do the same over here, and this is for board power. You're going to slide it in over here. Then you're going to tighten this down. You're going to do ground. Tighten this down as well. Then I'm going to fold this down, but I'm not going to lock it in place because you can see the shadow that's occurring with the light. So I'm going to move it up a little. So the next thing that we need to do to prepare this board is pop out the SD card. And we're going to put this in an SD converter here so that we can actually write to it. I'll put a link in the description of the video. And just so you know, no one's paying me or sponsoring me to do this tutorial. So I'm going to put this in here. You may hear a beep. And I'll show you what I'm doing now. So I'm going to go over to my desktop in a second. Let me just clean it up here for you. And we can see that the file currently is firmware.cur in all capital letters. That means that that was the last firmware load. So now I'm going to go over to VS Code. And inside VS Code, I'm going to click on the File Explorer. And you may not see this part, but I'm saying Open Folder. Then I'm going to my Downloads folder, then my Marlin folder, then my second Marlin folder. And those are extracted already, so I'm going to say Select Folder. Then I'm going to, inside VS Code, click on the Marlin folder, the Source folder, the core folder, then boards.h. Inside boards.h, I'm going to search on GTR_V, and that'll bring us to the actual board type. So I'm going to right click on that and copy it. Then I'm going to minimize the core folder, the source folder, and go to configuration.h. Inside configuration.h, I'm going to do a search on motherboard. And I'm going to highlight the ramps board that's here currently and paste over that. Then I'm going to scroll up and I'm going to change the serial port to -1. And I'm going to do a search on the A4988 to set up our stepper. And because we're working with just the x-axis, I need to enable that. And I also need to change it to the TMC2209. So I'm going to copy that and then paste it right here. Down below, I'll show you something in a moment having to do with this. So I might as well show you right now. So these are the defaults for default access steps per unit. They're going to equate to your configuration over here for configuration advanced.h. So I'm going to search on 800 real quick. And this will bring us to the actual settings for our access. So right now I'm going to change the 800 to 750. That's my favorite number for this. Now keep in mind that this is based on a root mean square calculation, or as a lot of people like to say, the square root of 2, which is 1.414 or 1.141. I think it's 414. But that's neither here nor there. But here's where I'm talking about where this is related to this number for your x-axis. Currently 80 has the equivalent microsteps of 16. If we were to change this, for instance, if we double this to 160, that means that we need to double this to 64. And so I'll show you another example or two. So if we were to do 320, then we need to change this to 64. I'm sorry, the one before that was actually 32. So I'll show you one more time. So if we go to 640, this would then be 128, and that's how microstepping works. So it would be 16 for 80, for 160 it would be 32, for 320 it'd be 64, and then for 640 it would be 128. And so if we were to go all the way to the extreme, so we were to change this to 1280, then we would need to change this to 256. And that's how it works. So now what I'm going to do is I'm actually going to search on sensorless homing after I set my TMC debug. So I'm going to say TMC debug. And this allows us, let me go back up one, to set up our debugging if we so need it. In this case, I usually use M122 to check to make sure that the steppers are okay. So I need to remove the comment here, and then I need to go to the second TMC debug and remove this as well so that we can enable it. Now I'll show you how to set up sensorless homing. So I'm going to search on sensorless, and that's going to be just too far for where we need to be. So I'm going to go up one. And I need to remove the comment to enable this. Then TMC 2209. There's the highest sensitivity and the lowest. I've personally found that the number 125 works for me. This other value that you're seeing is actually based on SPI configurations as default, and that would be the others. So we're going to avoid that for now because we're using the TMC 2209. So now I'm going to show you the sensorless homing bump that I discovered. This is kind of cool. So down here, if you were to home, it would go directly to the end of the access and stop based on the sensitivity of the overcurrent for the TMC 2209. But I like it to back off a little, and right now it's default for 2 when this is enabled. So I'm going to exaggerate it by moving it to 20. So it's going to hit the end of the axis, going to pause for a second, and then move out 20 from that. Now the 20 is not exactly 20. You're going to have to calibrate eventually these numbers so that they match up to the actual movement that they do. And that's unfortunately another tutorial within itself. So I'm just going to show you how to set this up for now. So I'm going to go over to platformio.ini, and we need to change the default environment. Right now it's for the Mega 2560 chipset, which we're not using. So we're going to search on GTR_V, and that'll bring us to our board environment. So I'm going to copy that. Then I'm going to scroll all the way back up to the top, and I'm going to change the default environment to that chipset environment that it specifies. So I'm going to click on the clean button here real quick just to clear out the previous build that I had done. And I'm going to click on the checkbox to actually build it. This may take a few seconds. It may fail, which has happened on occasion. One thing you can normally do if you think it's correct is rebuild again and see if it works. If not, go to the first error that you encounter, and that'll probably give you a description of what's occurring. Also, I have a Discord that is going to be in the description of this video. It'll allow you to either communicate with myself or somebody else in the Discord. A lot of people like to answer the question. So now that we have that done, in order to actually load the build, we have to go over to .pio, then build, then the Big Tree Tech folder here, and we're going to reveal an explorer. So I'll show you what this looks like. Just give me a second to get over to it here for you. So over here, here's the folder where our build took place. So to move this to our drive, which is on the USB D drive in this case, we're going to right click. We're going to go to send to. We're going to send it to the D drive. And so that's our firmware.bin. Next, we're going to go over to our workbench and we're going to install it. So I'm going to pop the drive out. I'm going to bring it over here. I'm going to pop this open and I'm going to slide this back into the board. It takes me a second to work it in because of the angle I'm working at here. Now that it's in, I'm going to connect the USB serial. Notice how I'm set to direct power, so I'm going to push this down for a second. I'm going to connect the power and the firmware will begin to load. You'll see a flashing light right there. Remember not to touch your board when it's energized because it's unsafe for you and the board. So now that that's working, we're going to go over to Pronerface, and inside Pronerface, we're going to connect to the board. Now, unfortunately, as you can see, the COM port that I have is COM port 1, which is not correct. So I need to bring up the actual device manager to check this. So I have it up on the screen over here, so I'll let you see what I'm looking at. So over here, down under the USB COM ports, you can see that it's COM port 4. That's the one that we need to use. So I'm going to go over to Pronerface again. And inside Pronerface, I'm going to change that COM port 1 to a COM port 4. I'm going to backspace and say 4. Then I'm going to click connect. And as you can see, it says the printer is now connected and online. Now that debug code that I was talking about for M122 will tell us the status of our connection. As you can see, it says OK right here, and then it'll continue to give us a status. But now what we want to do is actually move our axis. So I'm going to move it N, and it may not work correctly. So let's see what happens. The reason that it's not working correctly is, first, I have the power cord disabled, meaning it's not plugged in, so I'm going to remove the power for a moment, let it de-energize. I'm going to then take the plug and plug it in over here so that we can connect. And then I may have made another mistake where I forgot to invert the axis. So I'm going to move this over to the middle just in case and plug it back in. And so I'm going to disconnect, reconnect, and then I'm going to move 10. So I'm moving in the wrong direction. So I'll show you how to fix that real quick. And that involves going back over to the actual VS code. I'm going to disconnect the power. I'm going to pop out this drive right here. I'm going to pop it back into our USB connection over here for our device and plug it back in. And here's the mistake that I made. So inside VS code, you can see that there's something I forgot to set. And that has to do with inverting, because it's going the wrong way. So inside here, I need to go to configuration.h and do a search on invert. And right here, this is incorrect. So I'm going to change that to true. And then all you have to do is rebuild and then copy that over as soon as it's finished building. It'll be a very quick build. It'll probably be about 20 seconds. But at least I showed you the error or the mistake and how you can recover it from it. So after this completes, we're going to go back to the .pio, then build, then BigTree. Tech, we're going to right click on it and we're going to say reveal in Explorer. And then I'll show you that again. So over here in the actual desktop, you can see that I have the actual file right here that's just been compiled. So I'm going to right click and I'm going to send it to my D drive. Then I'm going to go back to my workbench. And I'm going to pull the drive out. I'm going to remove the actual drive and place it back in here. Then I'm going to plug it back in. And that should fix the problem. So let's see what happens. So if we go to Pronterface, and inside Pronterface we hit connect again. Printer is now online. We can check the actual status and it says okay. And now let's try and move 10. So it appears to be moving 10, no problem. Let's try homing. So it's going to home and then offset. So we know that everything is working and it's moving perfectly fine. And we can home and we get that offset bump. So if you like my tutorial, please press the like button and subscribe. And one other thing, I do now have an active Discord, if I haven't already mentioned it, where you can go and ask me questions, or somebody else that's in there is always willing to answer a question. And I also want to thank the people that have been giving to my Patreon account. It's greatly appreciated. One day it'll be able to help me offset the time I have to spend working, so that I can actually do this more full time for you. So thank you very much and have a nice day.